of Jennifer Lawrence, she has it all. The woman is absolutely talented. She's got Oscars on her shelf. She's also fantastically beautiful. And then she's got that girl next door vibe. Who wouldn't want to be with her? Well, apparently in this video, there's no shortage of dudes.
She is hot.
She sure is. Here we go. Tell you what, I'd like to bend her over a barrel and show her the 50 states, you know what I'm saying?
I don't know what that means.
Now, Jennifer Lawrence blew up with the first Hunger Games movie back in 2012. She was actually well on her way to being a household name in the years preceding that. She was a regular on the Bill Engvall show from 2007 to 2009, during which there were uncomfortable rumors that her and Graham Martin, who played her on-screen brother, were a couple in real life. Now, this has never been confirmed, and I can only imagine that seeing each other as brother and sister for 12 hours a day would have gotten in the way of any sort of love life. But, well, people thought it happened, which would be really weird.
It's spring break, Dad. Girls don't go wild in a one piece. I'm kidding.
With her looking like that, though, you can't blame the guy for trying his best. Following her run on The Bill Show, Jen was on the rise with a starring role in 2010's Winter Bone and her first appearance in the X-Men series the year following. The entire time, well, she was in a relationship with X-Men co-star Nicholas Holt. The pair struggled to remain together, breaking up only to get back together time and time again until July of 2014 when the two finally called it quits for good. Unfortunately, their breakup did not mean the end of the X-Men series, and the two continued to appear alongside one another, surely casting an awkward cloud over the set for many days on end. And I mean, like, they were both blue. It was just meant to be. Yeah, well, that looked just a little bit awkward. Seemingly more than anyone else, J-Law has been linked romantically to a number of her co-stars. She is well known for being a frequent on-screen partner of Bradley Cooper. From 2012 to 2015, she appeared in a film with him every year. They shared intimate scenes in Silver Linings Playbook and 2014's Serena, but 2013's American Hustle had Jennifer's attention focused, well, elsewhere. Yeah, that worked for me. In 2015's Joy, they were merely working partners, but this hasn't stopped the dating rumors from frequently plaguing the two, who have frequently denied that they do anything more than get together once a year for a couple months, and secretly hope they have sex scenes together. I'm for real.
Nikki hated when I talk like this. You feel like such a perv, but maybe we should change the subject.
I don't mind it.
Lawrence definitely gave Chris Martin the adventure of a lifetime, being seen numerous times with the Coldplay singer from June 2014 to August 2015.
37-year-old Chris made a Hunger Games reference during the show and then appeared to blow a kiss in the Oscar winner's direction.
With Jen fresh out of a relationship with Nicholas Holt and Chris a recent divorcee, the tabloids pegged these two as an odd couple. They tried to keep their love life as private as possible, but their attempts were as futile as their abilities to make their schedules work. And eventually, things fell apart. This worked out perfectly for J-Law's Hunger Games co-stars Josh Hutcherson and Liam Hemsworth, who both got linked to the star yet again as the trio were promoting the final Hunger Games film. She told Who Magazine that the three of them have frequent sleepovers during which they don't get a lot of sleeping done, and when asked to clarify what she meant, she said they have sex together. She was, of course, joking, but that hasn't stopped people from hoping her and Liam Hemsworth would wind up together.
You little double dicker.
Anyway, Liam's engagement to Miley, that's back on the table. Someone can assume that that dream is dead. At least we have this to look back on.
Liam and I grew up together. Liam's real hot.
I agree.
The later half of 2015 and the first half of 2016 marked J-Law's single days. But that doesn't mean we don't have anything to talk about. Being single is its own form of relationship, and Jen rocked the hell out of that. Of course, there were tough days. I know firsthand being single. Anyway, she told Vogue that zero magic was happening in her bedroom during a house tour. So little that her hymen was actually growing back. Now, if that's like, what's really happening with her? Someone's got to take that away again. I'd be the guy for the job. She probably won't. Anyway.
Why are you the way that you are?
And it's not like her time in the single life was without excitement.
Somebody, as a joke, bought me a bunch of butt plugs. It's a long story. It's a really, really long story.
And when she wasn't busy going to town on herself, she had plenty of men about town that she was interested in. And they weren't all that like the conventional ones. For starters, we got late night host and ex-SNL member, Seth Meyers. That guy's way batting out of his range, don't you think?
I had a really big crush on you.
Real? Okay.
Yes.
And Jen is the kind of woman who goes after what she wants.
So I was like, okay, you know what? I'm doing it.
But even for J-Law, things don't always work out.
And I was like, I think I'm gonna ask Seth Meyers out. I'm gonna give him my number. And she was like, honey, he's engaged.
But if you thought Seth Meyers was an unconventional crush, try this one on for size. It's not me. Anyway.
As I was randomly watching Curb Your Enthusiasm, and I said, I have so many sexual and boyfriend marriage feelings for Larry David, I feel like I'm gonna be sick.
Yeah, the Seinfeld creator and Curb Your Enthusiasm star, who's got 40 years on J-Law, makes her feel it below the belt. Fair enough. Can't see it myself, but to each their own. Finally, last summer, she started dating again, this time with Darren Aronofsky, the director of her latest film, Mother. Although he was already 22 when she was born, the couple are apparently quite serious and still going strong to this day, stepping out just a few weeks ago at TIFF. That didn't stop a little on-set awkwardness with Passengers co-star Chris Pratt when she was filming some of the film's more adult-orientated scenes. But, you know, I don't know, whatever. They never happened. She's with Darren, so now we know.
Because, like, with sex scenes, you don't know what to do. You're like, is it enough? Your worst nightmare, is it too much? Yeah. Are they going to be like, whoa?
But if you want to know more about Chris Pratt, fine. She apparently got very drunk to film the scene and felt incredibly guilty for kissing the once married man afterwards. The film didn't even do that well anyways, so I guess it was all for nothing. Good on you, Chris, though. You know, they never dated, but kudos to Darren Aronofsky for locking that down. And, we wish them good tidings. Anyways, guys, my name is Michael Cretton, and this is 6 Degrees of Hooking Up, which is just totally ridiculous. I'm just realizing that now. Let me know who you want to see in a future video on this series. Hit subscribe. We'll see you guys in another video.